Thank God that the brother's on the rise now. Woo! Endless celebrations all in my house.
Okay, so manager.
Manager. I'm going to back Klopp. Of course I'm going to back Klopp. But I want to hear your arguments as to why it should be Dean Smith over Klopp.
But this is a tough one. Because of what Smith has done over the... Like, since he came in. He joined us when we were 10th in the championship.
Yep.
And so getting us up from the 10th in the championship, getting us the playoff, beating Derby.
So hang on, with manager, are we talking what they've done since they've been there or... what they've done this season?
No, we're talking just this season, right, okay. But I'm just speculating.
You're reading the script.
but I don't know if it's just Dean Smith. Because we made behind-the-scene changes after last year.
Mm.
So we brought in the likes of Craig Shakespeare, who famously... was assistant manager when Leicester won the league.
Yeah.
And if you look at the way we're now playing, there's a lot similar in the way that Leicester played when they won the league, with the, like, more possession, more, like, a bit of a higher tempo, kind of controlling. Defending from the front, shall we say.
Yeah.
Like, the amount of times that Villa are pushing forward. So I'm not sure if I could give it to Dean Smith, but if we were doing a first and a second, I'd have to say Klopp and Craig Shakespeare.
Interesting. Yeah, like, as you've said, like, because you can't put your finger on whether it's Dean Smith or Dean Smith and his new set of backroom staff, I think Klopp's got to have it, because we've obviously not made changes in that area, and, you know, coming off the back of a win in the league, to then facing a very strange season, a very packed season full of games, because of, you know, the late/early start, and everything else that's gone with it, managing the injuries and stuff that we've had to, let's be honest, one of our biggest players, if not our biggest player, Van Dijk, and then obviously...
Well, he's definitely the tallest.
Our centre back partnership, not our defence. Even though we have had,
because there was a time when Trent and Robbo were injured as well.
So managing all that, and still managing to be top of the league at this point of the year, or joint top, if you want to be fair to United. You know, having all that adversity, I know it's because we are a top class team, and we should be there regardless of what's going on. But still, to manage through all that adversity and, like, all those problems, and still be at the top of the league or challenging for the top of the league at this point, I think he's done incredibly, really. But yeah, it's just it is a hat tip to how well you've done this season, and maybe how not so well we've done this season thus far, but obviously we've both had issues with injuries and stuff.
We lost Barkley. Maybe he would have got a chance.
He was performing very well for you when he was playing.
Maybe he would have got a chance to get into this team if he had played more.
Yeah, but then obviously
he had a hamstring injury where we were told he'd only missed 2 weeks. He's now been out for what, like 10, maybe 12.
It's upsetting that Thiago got injured as well, because I would like to have seen more of Thiago by this point in the season. Obviously, he's going to be... He's back fit now, and long may that continue, touch wood. So we can see more of him develop. I'd like to see Jota back, because hopefully a bit more competition for this position will make Firmino play a little bit better than what he has been doing. But yeah, we'll see. It'll be interesting.
We do a bit of transfer
talk? Let's do a bit of transfer talk, because, and something that has cropped up recently that I've seen that has made me quite angry, and, like, I don't really understand. I do and I don't to a certain degree, but is Klopp's come out saying that the likelihood that we're going to sign someone in this transfer window is slim. He's not saying it's not going to happen, but he's saying he doesn't intend on it happening, which... I don't know whether the term is worried or just... I'm concerned about, because, in my opinion...
When are Gomez and Van Dijk meant to be back?
Van Dijk's not supposed to be back till the very end of the season, if not like next season. And
what about Gomez?
Gomez, I don't really know. I don't think there's an actual sort of return date on him. I just know it's going to be... last I heard, it was also sort of a similar time period.
Because maybe he might know something that, like, after a couple of games in January, Gomez might be fit.
Yeah, like, and if he knows that...
He might then think... They might not want to admit it to the fans, because if it then falls apart, that's... then a big worry.
Yeah.
But if they're thinking that Gomez is going to be back, Fabinho's done well, or even Matip would be fine, then there's no need, really, to get a centre-back, and you could save the money and...
Yeah, but I don't think money is an issue.
Or save the wages.
Yeah.
Which is because I've heard a rumour of Alaba.
I don't want Alaba, I don't think. Like, I'm not debating that he's good, but I just don't... I don't know.
The thing is, though, do you need him?
No, we don't need Alaba. When we got our full defence fit, we do not need Alaba at all. However, in this current state we're in at the moment, with injuries plaguing our team and mostly our defence, I would bring in a young centre-back.
There was the rumour of Sven Botman.
Exactly. This is exactly the player on about when I was hinting towards.
That's apparently not happening anymore for some reason.
Yeah. When we were linked to him, I did a little bit of research on him, and I was just like, you know what, a young Dutch centre back that when Van Dijk's fit and he can take under his wing and develop him, I think that would have been absolutely quality. And I think getting him playing, I think that would have been something that would have been really good, because then we'd have had another option.
Would you not like to bring in from your youth, bring someone up that can then be coached by Liverpool, by your players around, and then...
I can see both sides of the argument. However, I don't understand why that's not been happening. Like, why did Hendo play centre-back the other day? When we could have bought him one.
You had two on the bench.
Exactly.
You had is it Nathaniel Williams? Is he the centre back?
One of the Williams. One of the Williams. Nico and another one. I can't remember off the top of my head. I'm having a mind blank. But yeah, I don't understand why we had to bring Hendo in to play that position when we've got people there that could have played that. Is that a lack of confidence in those youngsters? And if so, why aren't we looking at getting someone in that we can put confidence in? Who knows?
Yeah.
But, yeah, as far as Klopp's made me believe, we're not going to sign anyone in this transfer window, which, we'll make do. We've done well enough without them so far, so barring any more...
Yeah.
Horrendous injuries. Like, if Fab gets injured, then we're buggered. But, we'll see.
Yeah. So, there's not really been any massive transfers, has there?
No, not really.
United have obviously signed Diallo?
Yeah, Diallo or Diallo. Yeah.
Diallo, yeah.
Diallo, yeah. He signed in the summer, 18. But... He signed in the summer, but actually came now. So that was
they agreed to fee then, and they just had to go on like work, wait for the work permit, and
I see.
Like, okay. Agree personal terms and a fitness. That was why it didn't happen.
I see.
Haller gone to Ajax.
Yeah.
Or 20.5 mil.
I mean, that's good money for someone that's not really performed all that well at West Ham.
Yeah.
I think something that I saw the other day, which I'm really happy about, is I think Ozil's actually got a move away from Arsenal, which I think is only what he deserves, because he deserves to be playing football, regardless of all the politics and stuff, which I believe is the reason why he wasn't playing for Arsenal. I think there was stuff that he had said that wasn't agreed with, but he wasn't going to take what he said back, etc. I can't remember the ins and outs of it, but I think it was all politics. Yeah. Why I wasn't playing, and nothing to do with his fitness or anything.
No, there's a few rumours of where he's going to go.
Fenerbahce, wasn't it? I think
there's multiple Turkish clubs. There's DC United still. not sure.
But yeah, I think he really does deserve to go away and start playing football elsewhere, because he's too much of a good player to not be playing football.
Yeah.
And obviously, if Arsenal can ship him off, that's wages they're not having to pay then as well.
Yeah, because he's on a fair amount.
Yeah, he's on a big packet.
So Arsenal are one that are confusing me as well at the moment.
Because
they've loaned out Kolasinac. And they've loaned out, what's his name? Pablo Mari?
Is it Mari they loaned out? I thought it was Saliba they loaned
out. Yes, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Pablo
Mari, I know what you're thinking. But yeah, it was Saliba. I don't know, I think loaning out...
Who am I thinking?
No, Pablo Mari is a player, but it's Saliba they loaned out. But I think that's
Pablo Mari's 27 as well. So,
but I think that'd be good for Saliba to go get some experience under his belt, come back, hopefully a more polished player for Arsenal. That's what they need. But the Arsenal youth now, Arteta's putting some faith in the youth and playing them. They've come alive. Arsenal have looked a completely different squad in the last few weeks compared to. When they were in their relegation battle.
They signed another young defender.
All right.
They've signed... Oh, I'm going to butcher this name. Omar Ricky. He's Tunisian and he's 19 years old.
Right.
Centre-back.
Interesting.
They've signed him from Hertha Berlin. He's already been in England for a short amount of time.
Right.
He was in Man City's youth for a year or two.
Right.
I'm unsure about that one. Is that one for the future? But then you would have said the same about Saliba.
Yeah, I don't know. It's an interesting one. It's a strange one. I had heard that Arteta had been given what is known as the war chest, which was basically money so he could rescue Arsenal from whatever shit state they were in.
Well, they have taken out a loan with the Bank of England.
Yeah, I heard this. £120 million.
£120 million short-term loan.
I was joking about with my mate who's an Arsenal fan the other day, going, well, you're going to make a signing of £120 million, some big signing. You're just going to go out and sign one big player for that. But I doubt that'll actually happen. But
so do I. But other than really Arsenal doing some questionable transfers...
The transfer window has been pretty quiet, but January always is, until the end. You get a couple of short
Wolves have recalled a lot of their players. I think that's mainly because of the Jimenez issue.
Yeah.
They're not scoring as they should be. West Ham sold Haller. Robert Snodgrass has gone to West Brom, which could be good for West Brom. He's that kind of player.
I heard that Chelsea were interested in Donnarumma, but they don't need any more keepers, so they can just like fuck off.
Chelsea have as many keepers as Villa have.
Yeah, and that's too many.
Yeah, well, actually, we've now pretty much got three because. I always butcher his name. Klasinac. No, that's not his name. Cal, cut this bit out.
I do love you sometimes, Benny. We'll give up. We give up with his name because it doesn't matter anyway. Like transfer window. Transfer window is quite dead at the minute. No, nothing really to speak about. Only what obviously Klopp had come out saying that we weren't going to sign anyone, which I was hopeful we would, even if it was just a centre-back or something. But hopefully we'll be able to come back closer to the end of the transfer window and have a bit more to talk about.
Yeah, we could do a all four of us discussion about the transfer window.
Yeah, definitely, that'll be good.
Maybe on deadline day, day after deadline day, when all the deals have gone through.
Yeah, I agree.
There's nothing really at the moment.
Yeah. Excellent. Cheers for watching, guys.
See ya.
See you there.